Hey everybody, today I want to introduce you to onX Backcountry. It's the newest app from onX. It's a great tool for hikers and backpackers, as well as backcountry skiers and snowshoers in the wintertime. Let's take a look and I'll walk you through how to use the app. So today I'm going to plan a hike. Let's get started. First thing you're going to want to do is go ahead and open up the app. Now, if you've used onX Hunt or onX Off-Road before, you're going to be pretty familiar with how everything looks. Basically, the first thing you're going to see when you open up the app is your local area. The map is built on several different layers, so you can easily change the view depending upon what you want to see. So let's walk through what all these different buttons do and how to start planning your hike. The first thing to do is select the map mode you want. You'll find that button in the lower left-hand corner of the screen, and when you click it, you'll see that you can choose between trail and snow mode. Today, we're going to focus on trail mode, and we'll talk about snow mode later in the year. Underneath the modes, you can select your activity, which in this case is hike or backpack. Now let's talk about one of the most important features of this app, which is this button right here. This is what allows you to change your base map. So when you click this, you can select between a satellite, a hybrid, or a topo view, depending upon what you want to see. The regular 2D maps are fantastic, but there are also 3D versions of each one. I love this feature because it really helps you visualize what you're getting into before you head out on a hike. If you're on a desktop, you can view each base map in 2D or 3D. And if you're on your phone, you can view the satellite base map in 3D. But just a note, if you're an Android user, 3D is not yet available. In each mode, you'll notice it's super easy to tell what type of public land you'll be exploring based on the color outline. If you click on it, you can quickly tell whether you're on national forest, BLM, state land, a national park, a wildlife management area. You get the idea. You'll also be able to quickly see various recreation points, like national monuments, campgrounds, trailheads, and more. I've even noticed a brewery or two on the map. After you've scrolled around your local area, you can hit the crosshair button in the lower right-hand corner of the screen to see exactly where you are and center the map on your location. If you hit it again, the map will reorient based on the direction you're facing, which is an incredibly useful tool when you're out on a hike and want to make sure you're going the right way. So if you move up to the top right-hand corner of your screen, you'll find the weather bug. Click on that and you'll get a ton of information, like temperature, wind speed, sunset and sunrise times, plus a weekly and hourly forecast, and even moon phase information. Just above that tab, you can select either temperature or wind, which lets you see what either of those are doing at various weather stations across the map. Above the weather bug is a search function where you can look up particular trails, campsites, or whatever else you want. All right, now let's find a trail. As you look at the map, you'll notice various trails around your location. Some of them look like this, which you're probably familiar with, and these are called core trails. One cool thing about onX Backcountry is that when you zoom in on these trails, you can easily see what the steepness or gradient is. So as you can see here, when I zoom in on the trail, parts of it become either green, yellow, orange, or red, depending upon how steep they are. That is a super helpful planning tool, especially when you're on the trail and you want to know just how hard that next section is going to be. Then you can tap on the trail itself to learn more about it. The blue trails are called backcountry adventures, and if you click on one, you can see just how much more information there is than with a core trail. This guidebook content is uploaded by experts, and it's packed with useful information about your hike and what to expect along the way. It's just like having a really good guidebook right in your pocket with a full synopsis of the trail and photos. All right, now let's take a look at the bottom of the screen and pick a hike. So the first thing I'm going to do is hit the crosshair button to get back to my location. Now I'm going to hit the Discover tab and pick a hike. That's going to bring up a bunch of nearby trails, and I'm going to pick one that I want to do. So if I click on Alamos Vista Trail, I can scroll through all of this information about the hike, and then I can move on to the next button here, which is Offline Maps. Since this is the hike we're going to do, I'm going to go ahead and click Offline Maps on my phone and then select New Map. You can name the map, and then you can also choose what resolution you want the map to be. 10 miles wide resolution tends to be the best option for human-powered adventures, but in this case, I'm going to choose 5 miles wide because it's an afternoon hike and it's going to give me the best detail and clarity in offline maps. Once you click that, you can see the download progress and make sure it's all there before you head out. All right, now that we've got this downloaded, it's time to hit the trail. One thing to keep in mind is that only some of the guidebook data is available offline, so if you want all of it, make sure you take a screenshot before you head out. The last thing you might want to look at while you're at home planning your hike is the tools section. Here you can measure line distance or add a waypoint, but we're going to talk about waypoints once we're out on the trail. All right, now that we've got our hike planned out, let's hit the trail. Okay, now that we're at the trailhead, the first thing we're gonna do is go into offline mode, which will save battery and utilize those maps that we downloaded earlier. It's also a good idea to put your phone into airplane mode, which will help save that battery. The next thing you're gonna wanna do is set a waypoint for where you parked so you can easily find your way back. There are two ways to do this. Go into the tools section and select either add waypoint, which will drop a waypoint in the middle of the screen, or mark my location. I prefer mark my location because it's a little quicker. You can then click on the waypoint and change the icon to trailhead. You'll notice there's a bunch of different options here for various icons. They're in alphabetical order. All you do is scroll down to trailhead, select that, and you're good to go. All right, now let's start the tracker and we're ready to go. One thing I like to do is add waypoints or potential campsites ahead of time, which is really helpful if you're planning a longer hike. While you're on the trail, it's also helpful to take another look at that elevation profile so you can see what's coming up. Along the way, you can mark waypoints even in offline mode and add detailed notes and photos, and of course, those icons that we looked at before. You can also use the line distance tool to gauge the distance between one point and another to let you know how far you have to go. All right, once you've finished your hike and you're back at the truck, go ahead and stop the tracker. If you're like me and sometimes you forget to do that before you drive away, that's all right. You can edit your track later using Trim Tracker. That's great because it means you won't end up with an inaccurate track. Once you get back in a cell service, you can easily find your track as well as any waypoints you've created in the My Content section of the app, and then you can easily share that with friends. All right, so there's a look at how to use onX Backcountry for planning a hike and when you're out on the trail. Hopefully this helps you find some more hikes around you and get out there a little more often.